this afternoon from Mako Gold is Peter Ledwidge. Peter, good to see you again. Good afternoon.
Yeah, nice to see you again, Andrew.
Look, big day for the company here. Capital raise, $10 million. Strong support by all accounts, Peter. Just tell us a bit more.
Yeah, absolutely. It was, oversubscribed by a significant amount. And, we did the wise thing. We're trying to raise a minimum of five and takeovers up to 10. And we get offered a lot more than that. But obviously, we keep the dilution under control. So we took 10. And it allows us to really hit our projects hard, do a lot of drilling.
Well, give us a little bit more information. Hit them how? What are the plans?
Well, on our Napier project, which is a large project, it's 30 kilometers north-south. It's almost several projects within a project. So we've been focusing on the Chaga prospect, which we're advancing towards maiden resource. So that's where all our drilling's been going into really over the last year or more. But we drilled three other prospects in 2018, and other than a few holes that we did announce in the last ASX release, we haven't gone back and drilled those. So now that we're fully funded, we can forge ahead on the maiden resource on Chaga, and go back to the other ones and then really start hitting them hard, because we did get some very good results in 2018 on them, and so we've been aching to go back there. So it makes us pretty excited. We're pretty excited about going back there.
So you're due to kick off some diamond drilling imminently at the Chaga prospect, are you?
Yeah, we're actually in the middle of a 10,000 meter drill program. That's before raising this $10 million. So we're halfway through there. We took about a two and a half week break because it's really heavy rains right now. So we're planning on starting that up again next week. So that's combined RC and diamond. And on the Gogbala prospect, we're starting a IP survey in two, 3 weeks. And as soon as that's done, then we're going to launch a major drill program on that. But we're also going to be drilling on the other prospects and all RC and diamond. It's good to have the ability to do that. And, we like to spend our money fast, but we spend it into the ground.
So you say you took a bit of a break from the current drill program. Are we expecting some results from the first part anytime soon?
We've actually got 15 RC drill holes that we're waiting assays on. And while we're having that break, it allows our geologists to catch up on the core logging and splitting 14 diamond drill holes. And those diamond drill holes also give us a lot of structural information that help us target, future drilling more. So we're actually changing the orientation of our drilling and when we start up again because of the diamond drilling.
So how many rigs have you got on site?
Well, right now, just the one, but we're bringing the second one in November. And, we plan on having, two rigs running from here on, sort of thing. So good position to be in, and that's what shareholders want to hear. Although we have to go do, soil sampling programs and IP geophysical surveys, shareholders want to see a drill turning. And on that note, we recently got granted another permit in Côte d'Ivoire, so we're going to start exploration on that, and that's going to be with soil sampling, and then we'll follow that up with drilling.
So it sounds like a real ramp up in activity for you. Looking ahead, what's the story? It's all about exploration, all about drilling, is it?
Yep, it is. So, targeting, our maiden resource in the early part of 2021. And, keep tuned, for possible new discoveries on our new permit. And we're waiting for another permit to get granted as well. And then on Gogbala, where we already, put in 24 very wide space drill holes over basically 4 kilometers in 2018, we get some really nice results on that, 12 meters at 5.5 grams per ton. So, we're just really excited about going back and drilling that again. So, yeah, lots of news flow coming up.
So you're excited. Across the board, you're pleased with progress and developments, are you?
Yeah, for sure. And, we're doing what the shareholders want us to be doing.
From a personnel perspective, Peter, you've had a couple of board changes, have you?
Yep, that's correct. Because we are moving towards a maiden resource, and after that, there's a normal studies that come after that, scoping studies, feasibilities, and everything. We brought on a real solid engineer that that used to be with Griffin, and Steve Zaninovich. I said his name right. And we've known him for a number of years, and it was really nice for him to come on our board, and he'll add a lot. And as well, one of our current directors moved up into the chair, and he's a corporate lawyer, Michele Musillo, and he's the one actually negotiating the Cardinal takeover. So our current outgoing chairman retired, and because we like to have a small board and keep the costs in the ground. And so it was a good move for us, and one step further for the company.
Well, busy times and some new faces at Mako Gold. You say lots of news coming, Peter, so just remind us near term, you're restarting the drill program, you've got some assays to come. What else can we look forward to?
The beginning expiration on the newly granted permit, and then hopefully we think that the second permit's going to get granted shortly as well, and basically from here on there'll be drill results at least once a month, and so that's what keeps that momentum going.
Very good, Peter, nice to see you. Thanks for the quick update.
Yeah, and thanks for catching up with me again.